वी हैव विद अस अनदर फ्रॉम आचार्य वेदा शंकर जी. वी हैव आचार्य कल्की कृष्ण जी whom we really want to honor from this august platform. He has unleashed the majestic splendor of Vedic values and Vedic sciences, especially the ones pertaining to Vedic Jyotish, Vedic Sthapatya, Vedic Vastu Shastra, Vedic Yajna, Vedic Yoga, Vedic Mantra Vigyan, Vedic Varna Chikitsa, the color therapy, Vedic Yantras, Vedic Ratnas, Ayurveda, Prakritik Chikitsa, Vedic Ahar Vigyan, Palmistry, Numerology, and all other allied sciences. So these are all, it was a whole compact which we used to have because of lack of whatever research, whatever things. So we really want to honor Acharya Kalki Krishnanji, and we will be requesting him to stay back for his elaborate exhaustion. यंत्र विज्ञान, क्योंकि कलयुग में कहते हैं कि यंत्र ने प्रभावशीलता ले ली है. यंत्र हैज अ डिफरेंट कॉनोटेशन इन द वर्ड ऑफ ज्योतिष, एस्ट्रोलॉजी एज वी कॉल इट. वी हैव विद अस आचार्य कल्की कृष्णन जी विद अस, हुम वी दिस फोरम हैड द ग्रेट फॉर्चून एंड प्रिविलेज टू फेलिसिटेट विद द हीलिंग ऑनर 2021 इन द नेम ऑफ डॉक्टर केशव बलिराम हेडगेवार. मेडिकल एस्ट्रोलॉजी इज अ वेरी प्रोफाउंड डिसिप्लिन. पहले राजवैद्य एक एस्ट्रोलॉजी में भी निष्णात होते थे, और नाड़ी के परीक्षण के साथ साथ वो कुंडली के परीक्षण के साथ बता दिया करते थे द फोरकास्टिंग मेथड, व्हाट वी यूज बिलियंस ऑफ डॉलर्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स एंड एम्पिरिकल एविडेंसेस. सो दिस इज अनदर पैराडाइम विच एस्ट्रोलॉजी इज अ वेरी फाइन साइंस, एंड एमिनेंट्स लाइक प्रोफेसर सुभाष काक, दे हैव बीन राइटिंग अ लॉट अबाउट एस्ट्रोलॉजी फ्रॉम अ वेरी वेरी कंप्यूटर साइंस पर्सपेक्टिव्स. And in fact, the astrologers are the one who use technology, the tools to predict, tools to do the complex mathematical computations phenomenally. So over to Acharya Kalki Krishnanji to give his exhortation on this healing forum, how to integrate the yoga of healthcare and astrology, Jyotish, as we call it. Sir, Acharya Ji, pranam.
Pranam, Acharya Ji. Thank you, Surabhi and Raghav, and Rethink India for giving me this opportunity, wonderful opportunity. Today is International Yoga Day. The literal meaning of yoga is the union, to add upon. And the efforts you are inculcating upon to add and combine so many things you have for the welfare of humanity in general, it is worth appreciation, and I bow upon before you, you all people. So with the brand Astro Devam, working upon astrology, Vastu, Yoga, Ayurveda, I also exposure to the Ayurveda and Yoga to a reasonable extent. So we are combining all these things to how we can achieve the holistic health of a person. And astrology is the very deep science. It is called Vedanga, and the eyes of the Veda. Vedas, the source of knowledge, cannot see without the astrology. So astrology is such a deep science. It categorizes every human being. When you open horoscope, it categorizes in the elemental way, what element is prime, what element is minor, and everything you can know upon about any person. And medical astrology has reached to such an extent that many doctors known to me, and I have taught so many doctors, senior doctors in the Delhi NCR, even from other countries also, sometimes from some great big hospitals, when they see that the patient and their family is unable to afford expenses, sometimes they send them to me to see what is the probability of being healthy, what is the probability of success of this surgery. So astrology has reached this thing, medical astrology branch has reached this perfection, that you can see the probability of getting success in a surgery or not, and so many things, and there are specific formulas. This is not a Baba type things you can understand, and it can be taught to any person. But the most essential thing today I can say that how these sciences, which has Indian background and our background in our scriptures, how they perceive a person, actually modern science, I don't want to criticize, I'm not going to be critic, but how the ancient Indians ethos see a person, this is elaborated in a very, very beautiful manner in the Taittiriya Upanishad of Krishna Yajurveda, that the body you see with your naked eye is not the only body. They have used the word panchakosha, meaning five layers of bodies. The body which we create in the modern science is the gross body. It is called anumaykos. You are born in a very little, in a very little form, but with the conjunction of force and everything, you grow like anything. So this is the body created by the anna or food or what energy in what your form you consume. But beyond this, there are so many bodies. And they say panchakosha means five layers. The other four layers are pranamaykosha, manomaykosha, vigyanmaykosha, and andamaykosha. The pranamaykosha is the energy body. You are working, we all are engaged in this wonderful seminar and our interaction forum. But after Raghav Naidu feeling, I am feeling exhausted, but he didn't do anything physically. But his energy body has depleted to some extent. That's why he might be feeling exhausted. So how you handle the energy body? The another is that I am getting very brief because the subject is so vast, it can go for hours and days. So another is manomay body. This is the mental body. How you are feeling depressed, you are feeling elated. Young man feeling heartbroken after Daniel from his girlfriend. So his manomay kosha might be depleted to a great extent. And then beyond this manomay kosha is vigyanmay kosha. This is the intellect body. How discriminate the things, how memorize the things, how your buddhi works. Jo hai. And the last one is the anandamay kosha. This is the ultimate. We call our Ishwar, our God, Sachidanand, who has the anand is the basic factor of the Ishwaratva or Godhood. So anandamay kosha ultimate, when you are in bliss. But for being in bliss, for being in anandamay kosha, you have to correct annamay kosha, pranamay kosha, manomay kosha, vijnanamay kosha. So when the modern science treats the physical body annamay kosha, how it is going to treat the pranamay kosha, manomay kosha, and vijnanamay kosha, this is very important. And the ancient Ayurvedic practitioners used to heal all these koshas and layers and or seeds of the body. Unfortunately, I used to interact with all practitioners of all the types, allopathy, Ayurveda, homeopathy, jo hai. But somehow I have pain and suffering in my heart that in the current modern Ayurvedic colleges, the Ayurveda is not being taught with such a deep understanding. What was the thought and concept in the ancient times, it is not being passed upon to the contemporary Ayurveda practitioners. I'm making an assessment, but it is my observation after interacting with current Ayurveda practitioners. And in the allopathic system, there is no method to understand. There are psychiatrists who have to understand the manomay kosha, but they are handling in such a some different way, not in a way our ancient scientists or rishis or munis, whatever you call them, they you handle. So today on this great platform, I am fortunate to share with some great luminaries of India. I am not worth and I don't want to compare me with these gentlemen who are really worthful and contributing to the great concept. But I want to inculcate this thought into me, into the mind of all the persons who are listening, that we have to develop this concept in a very holistic, samagrata se, in the very holistic and combined way, so that we reach the ultimate welfare of the person, he is the person who remain in the blissful way, a blissful condition of mind or anandamay kosha. And astrology has so many tools. In the same way, I had to share my pain that in the modern astrology, people have very less time. Everyone wants to make money. So they are not going to deep. They want to just make shallow predictions. What will happen? This is not what, this is not the ancient rishis. Especially the Lagad Rishi, who created this Vedanga called astrology or Jyotsha, he didn't have that thought. But I'm making this request with my folded hands that everyone should come on a common platform so that we can reach and we create paradigm and model and which the backing of ancient science with the contemporary thoughts and the experimentation. Thank you all. Thank you all again. I'm making this request.